and give their son also of her. Yea, will I bless her, and she shall be a mother of all nations.
Amen.
No, here you are. You feel like a simple church sister. And you feel like so you're burning in the spirit. And you feel like so you will never mount up to anything good. But hear ye the word of Almighty God. God is about to make you the head and not the tail. He's about to turn your barrenness into fruitfulness. He's about to turn somebody who could be burning in the spirit into a mighty woman of God. Reach over to your neighbor and say, neighbor, God is about to change some stuff in your life. Somebody say yes. Reach over to 3 people and tell them it shall come to pass. Now watch this. Have you ever received a promise for you, to you, and when the time came for the promise to be fulfilled, it did not come true? How do you feel? You feel disappointed? You feel let down? Because hope deferred made the heart sick. But God said to tell you, he's not a man that he should lie. And the thing that he's promised to you for years, the thing that you think that he has forgotten, that's him about to give it back to you. And not only that, I'm about to give it to you full measure, pressed down, shaking together, and running over. Can I preach to somebody? The Bible tells me of a man named Job. Somebody say yes. Job lost everything. Oh my God. And while Job was there, not knowing that at the end, at the set time, there was something that was there for him, waiting for him. Can I talk to somebody? And the Bible said that in all these things, Job sinned not. In everything that he went through, he did not sin. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. When you're going through something, it doesn't mean the promise of God over your life has changed. God is not a covenant breaker. He said, my covenant will I not break. Now will I alter the thing that is gone forth out of my mouth. If he said it, it will come to pass. Somebody say yes. Sometimes while you're waiting on your promise, the horse of hell will come to you while you're waiting. And watch this. Okay, who can I use now? Illustration time. I'm gonna use this. Alright, you come. Alright. Here's Sister Bennett. God gave her a promise. God did not give her the time when the promise should come to pass. So this is now the promise, right? And over here is time. Now watch this. You're going to get this body that she. Since the Phoenix is over there, God also promised her something that she should receive at a specific time. Watch this. Here is God now. She is here walking towards her promise, and she's here.
My God.
Sister Bennett now was here, and God gave her her promise. Give her back my water. Right? So God gave her her promise. God was not ready for you to receive yours yet, because he was preparing you to handle what you're about to receive.
Yes.
This is the plan of the enemy. The enemy don't want you to focus on what she got and begin to take your eyes off the one who's giving you the promise. Come on, no man. Understand direction. And here you are. When you walk to where God is, and you're supposed to get your promise, instead of looking to God for it, oh my God, the devil will try to guard you, to envy those who get deals already. But not so. That devil is a liar. I plead the blood of Jesus against every distraction. Somebody say yes. Thank you. My God, I know it. I remember Jesus and mercy. And I was supposed to get engaged to my wife. Jesus have mercy. There were some other folks who got engaged before me. And then all of a sudden, hell began to target me now. Saying, look, this person already get their promise. And I'm saying, Lord, what happened to me? And God said, son, I got to prepare you for what you're about to walk into. So somebody here, God have a promise for you. Don't get distracted, my brother. Don't get distracted, my sister. Just hold on until your change comes. Cause God will come through for you. Cause God will not forget his promise. Oh my God. Somebody say yes.
Hey, hallelujah. Jesus.
Understand this. Oh my God. Sometimes we can miss our blessing. We can miss the thing that God has for us because hell try to distract us. Because if you ever walk into your promise, oh my God, hell get nervous. Hell get trembled. Because God said, you're a mighty woman of God. And God said, you're a mighty man of God. If you ever walk into that promise, into that anointing, our hell will have to back up. So the devil don't want you to reach here. So we'll try to put distraction to your left and to your right. But just focus, my sister. Focus, my brother. God is about to take you into your promise and into your destination. And I hear somebody might be saying, oh my God, so what? I messed up. I couldn't get it right. I got a word for you tonight. God said, remember the children of Israel. I have promised them something. I promised them a land flowing with milk and honey. Now what could be better than that? But before they reached the promised land, they messed up and sinned against God. And God said to tell you, even if you messed up and even if you sinned, he still won't change his mind. That is a God of love and a God of mercy. That is a God of a second chance. All you have to do is run back to him. Somebody say yes. The children of Israel, they cry out to God and God hear them. Oh my God, I don't care what you did, when you did. God said you will walk into your promise. All you have to do is just run to him. And there is still a fountain. Oh God, I feel the preach tonight that is filled with blood.